Most people in America are expecting that American sizes for clothing actually match American standards. When a man is looking for a pair of pants, he is expecting that the sizes that are placed on clothing by companies and manufacturers are truthful. When he purchases the clothing, he will pick them up and place them across his waist to make sure that they will fit marginally well. He will also check to make sure there's extra room by 2 to 4 inches to care for the fact that we all have a bit of a rotundness to us. But when a man goes into a department store and purchases a pair of pants that an employee likes to play with, he gets pissed off. When a man puts on the counter a extra large size and he finds that when he gets home he's got a large, he knows that employees have played a game. The liars of America play those games. They put people in play to change things out. I believe I told the story of buying pants or shorts from City Trends. The first pair, when I got them, I checked them out immediately and I got out of the store because they don't really have dressing rooms that are careful for men, and I simply found that they didn't fit me and they were too small because I didn't really know my size. So I went back into the store. I tried to make an exchange. The manager would not take my shorts back without the receipt, so I had to go back out to my pack and hunt for the receipt. I went back later and got the exchange. I made the perfect exchange and I checked the shorts to make sure they'd fit. I kept them in a bag, I kept them on my property, and when I got back to them the next day, they were more than obviously visually not the pants or the shorts I had purchased that day. They were shorts that did not have the proper taggings in them. Now this is a game that people like to play, that I'm going to provide those shorts you wanted to buy to someone else. It's also a game when people monkey a receipt. They don't put price tags on sunglasses, or they don't put price tags on clothing. So that when you take those clothing to the register and say, "I'm sorry, there's no tag on this, how much is this?" it gives a thieving employee the right to try to cut you out of the right prices. Now, if you don't know what that means, then you don't know how people are today. That there are some communities that think, this shirt belongs to our community, it doesn't belong on you. But that's not true. People in America have the right to choose their own fashion, however the Lord above leads them. Something I know about living my life with a pendulum and using a pendulum practice to utilize my faith in Odin and the Lord Most High over all the earth and all the nations and all the races and every living creature that He has created in this world is that He knows the clothing that I need for the next position I'm going to. Every single time I traveled with my vehicle and He said, "Please buy this shirt," I'd be like, "I'm not sure about that," because it wasn't my preference. But then I discovered the next time I was going to that everybody was wearing them, and then I understood that Jesus Christ knows how to find everything I need. In this world, we know who is who and what is what by how they behave behind a counter. It doesn't matter how sweet and wonderful your employee could produce and present to people, but if they're playing in changing out tags on clothing, if they're playing in using a bad pair of pants to replace a good pair of pants, or if they're playing in, "Okay, I see he's buying those, somebody quick get the different size and we'll screw him at the register," then you've got a real problem, employee. You see, employees like to have power, but the power they take is not the power that they make. Corporations do things incorrectly. The pants that I just purchased to keep myself safer at night are supposed to be a large, so I have a little bit more room. But what I found is that they don't fit like that at all. I have lost 16 inches off my waist, so a large should be plentiful on me. But what I found when I went to put them on is that they fit more like a small or medium to me. I do not like companies that lie about sizing. We do not need people being fearful of their weight. We do not need to be telling women or men that they are too large today. We must be importing companies, fabrics, wherever the hell we get our fashion from, whether it's France, Milan, or whatnot, even Japan. That if it's a large, it's a true large. If it's a medium, it's a true medium. People have the right to presume that those things will fit them. Because when we give a gift, the last thing we want to happen is it doesn't fit the person we give them to. Openly, one time in my life, I made a mistake when I designed a garment for a friend of mine, and it turned out it didn't quite fit her. She was sort of miffed about that, but she was much older than me, and felt like that I should have taken it back. I'm like, I can't take a specially designed shirt back, and that fucking thing cost me $50 to make, so I can't do that. I don't have that kind of money. And it was my fault. But openly, she still wore it, and it looked pretty hot on her. But that's not the point. The point is that people don't always know other people's sizes. But when I bought the large, I expected it to fit as a large would. Now, in life, we have moments of time to speak the truth about the things that we observe, the things that we see, and the things that we feel. What I find offensive is that I can walk into a Dollar Tree and some little Mexican 9-year-old kid is trying to play up too close to me, and the next thing I know that the glasses that are in my pocket are gone.